Welcome back. 2020 Democratic presidential candidate Pete Buttigieg facing backlash after questioning President Trump's faith.
The candidate telling USA Today, quote, "I'm reluctant to comment on another person's faith, as he should be. But I would say it's hard to look at this president's actions and believe that they're the actions of somebody who believes in God."
Here to respond is Pastor Robert Jeffress, a Fox News contributor who has prayed with the president. Pastor, what do you make? Welcome, first of all.
Thank you.
What do you make of this comment by Buttigieg about the president's faith?
Well, it's absolutely outlandish for somebody to make a comment like that who's never had any interaction with the president and certainly has never prayed with him like I have. And if you read this interview, Buttigieg is objecting to the idea that President Trump believes in God for two reasons. He says, first of all, President Trump and conservative Christians like me spend our time talking about things that Jesus never talked about, like abortion. Pardon me? I think Mayor Pete better go back and read his Bible. Jesus said, "Thou shalt not murder." Jesus said it would be better for somebody to have a millstone tied around his neck and thrown into the sea than to harm a child. Jesus did address the issue of abortion. But Buttigieg also said that Trump isn't humble enough to believe in God. And look, at a dinner not long ago, I was with President Trump, and he said to a group, he said, "You know, Pastor Jeffress says I'm not a perfect Christian, but I am a great leader." And that's true. I mean, there are no perfect Christians. We're all sinners who need a Savior. But as somebody said, God doesn't choose perfect people. He chooses people who are perfect for the job. And there are tens of millions of Christians like me who believe that President Trump is perfect for the job, not of National Sunday School teacher, sure, but of President of the United States.
King David is certainly a good example of that. And speaking of Israel, our own Secretary of State did an interview, talked about our commitment to the state of Israel. Listen to this.
To see the remarkable history of the faith in this place and the work that our administration has done to make sure that this democracy in the Middle East of this Jewish state remains, I'm confident that the Lord is at work here.
Pastor, the New York Times pounced right away. They said, "No Secretary of State in recent decades has been as open and fervent as Mr. Pompeo about discussing Christianity and foreign policy in the same breath. That has increasingly raised questions about the extent to which evangelical beliefs are influencing American diplomacy." How dare they, Pastor?
Well, to the left, it's the unpardonable sin that a conservative Christian would allow his beliefs to in any way influence other parts of his life, including his policy. But I doubt the left objected when Martin Luther King Jr. rightly allowed his Christian faith to impact his views on civil rights, or for the Christian abolitionists to allow their Christian faith to cause them to eradicate slavery. And let me say, Pete, what's really going on here. The left cannot conceive that God is at work using President Trump to protect Israel like he used Queen Esther 3,000 years ago.
But Pastor,
and the reason they can't...
Well, Pastor, I just want to jump in there for a little bit and push back on you some because, you know, Dr. King, of course, was not the Secretary of State. Now, do you believe there's a space for a Secretary's religious beliefs to coincide with policymaking of an administration?
Look, there are sound geopolitical reasons, apart from the Bible, to support Israel. They're our only reliable ally in the Middle East. But I think it makes sense for us as a country, President Trump, to be on the side, the right side of history and of God on this issue. And look, what's really going on here is the left, number one, hates Israel. They believe the Israelis are illegally occupying that land. Secondly, they hate Donald Trump. They can't believe God would use Trump in any significant way. And thirdly, the left really hates God. They say they love God, but the God they serve is an imaginary God who loves abortion and hates Israel. The true God, the God of Scripture, hates abortion and loves Israel. That's the big difference.
Pastor, thank you very much for your time this morning. We appreciate it.
Thanks for